Hello everyone. Welcome to IQI Phuket Weekly Talk. My name is Supha from IQI Phuket. IQI is also a member of JUI. So we will be having weekly talk every Thursday of the week at 10 a.m. Thailand time. So in our program, we usually talk about properties in Phuket and also update about Phuket Island. So what is the update Phuket Island today? Today, nowadays, we don't have to wear masks in a public area anymore. So, but if you enter in a closed area or air conditioned area, you still have to wear masks. But seem like everyone kind of familiar with not wearing masks in a public area. So everyone just, you know, spend their daily life normal in Phuket, Thailand now. So not too much restriction, not too much restriction now. So if you're thinking, oh, when you come to Thailand, when you come to Phuket, you have to keep your mask on all the time. No, not for now. Also, you know, many people ask me, they need to do any special request when they want to come to Thailand, come to Phuket. So now if you are vaccinated at least two doses vaccinated, then you can travel to Thailand. No need to ask for any special request. For those who mostly now the restriction is less than before, so welcome to Phuket. So if you want to travel now, it's a good time. It's rainy season in Phuket nowadays, but still we have still some sunshine and beautiful sunset and nice beaches. Not too crowded tourists. I noticed that nowadays they have many Australian people and many Arab or Dubai from Dubai, visitor from Dubai and India in Phuket now. So welcome all though. So today's topic, we are going to talk about sinking fund and maintenance fee. So what are those? What are sinking fund and maintenance fee? The house owner of property, such as condominium, apartment, service apartment, villas or house with ground in the compound or in the project, have to pay for maintenance fee and sinking fund. Yeah, it is compulsory for everyone. I mean, for every owner of the resident that they should pay. Yeah, before you going to buy a property, it is good step to understand how both funds are working, how the maintenance fees work, and how the sinking fund works. So first, what is the maintenance fee? The maintenance fee is like collect the fee that collect in advance, monthly fee in advance to keep to spend in a keep up of the property for fixing and repairing the communal area, for example, common pool or the common public area, the garden, the street light outside of the private resident or private home or private rooms. Mm. So this collects monthly in advance, and some development or some residence area, they ask to pay 1 year advance. But really depends on each management company. So who determine the monthly maintenance fee? The residence associate will determine the monthly maintenance fee, and also every member of the house or the condominium rooms or the apartment will be a member of associate, and also you can get the right to vote and get to attend annual meeting. Back to the who determine the monthly maintenance fee is determined by the member of association. Yes. And the next one, how to calculate maintenance fee. The final calculation of the maintenance cost is based on said sharing percentage, which is depends on many factors related to your property. For example, these are the factor that related type of unit, share access points, how many share or how many public access points to share, and share facility that you have access to. You know, some development or some project, they have like fitness center, fitness gym room to share, swimming pool, communal swimming pool to share. Yes. And also the some more factor to consider is total floor size and the space. So those are maintenance fee. So now, what is the sinking fund? A sinking fund is the money that has been charged over a period of time to pay for the future works and repair to common area. It is very similar to the maintenance fee. Yeah, it does share some similarity of the sinking fund because of the maintenance fee, and also based on the area of each unit per square meter. And both funds are proposed to the proposal to collect collect both funds to keep up the property, keep up the area or the residential to make it, you know, look nice all the time, even 5 years pass by, 10 years pass by. So if you want your property or your residential or your village or your project to look good, you have to look at the maintenance fee and sinking fund as well. Some owner doesn't want to pay for maintenance fee and sinking fund. Think about like this: if you don't have money to pay for you know, repairing or to pay for state manager or security, then your residents won't have those kind of service. It will look not very up to standard. No security, no cleaning, no trash collection. So some development, they collect only small fee, right? Small fee of monthly maintenance and sinking fund. Then the service will be, you know, you pay high, you get high, you get a good service, good quality and standard service. You pay less, what kind of worker or what kind of service you will get. So you can just imagination like that. Yeah. So do you really have to pay for this fee? Pay for the maintenance fee and sinking fund? Yes, you have to, or else your property or your project or your village will not look nice like at the beginning, you know, when time passed by. If you don't keep your property, or you're not taking care of the public area, the street light, the garden along the street, along the walkway, or the communal pool, the public area, if no one take care, it will run down, it will be look doesn't look nice. And also if you're willing to sell your property, the buyers will also look at, you know, the surrounding or the public area or the communal area. If the communal area is not will maintain or will keep up, then the chance to sell the property, the condo, the house or the villa is less. So far, do you think you should pay for sinking fund and maintenance fee? You got your answer, right? Well, if you still hesitate to pay, the building management department also can take a legal action against you. You will also lose your voting right at the management company annual general meeting. Yes. I think, you know, every member of the resident or every house owner or condominium owner should be responsible for monthly maintenance fee and also sinking fund. Some people might have question if they sell their property or their villas or their condominiums, would they get their sinking fund back? In this case, it's case by case. Some people, you know, they think every detail, every cost, every profit that they're going to get back. But in generally, sinking fund is one-time payment, right? And if you sell your property, it's attached to your property. But some other seller, they think very detailed. They think every detail. They calculate every detail. So the in the sale purchase agreement, that they need the refund of sinking fund back, because sinking fund is a is quite a number, not big number, but yeah, is like 100k, 100,000. This is I'm talking about Thai baht. 100,000 to 200,000 for like a trip for the villas and condominium, maybe less. Depends on many factors, like I mentioned before, per square meter. And also if you hire a professional management company, then you have to pay more expensive. That's it so far for the maintenance fee and sinking fund. If you have any question, you can leave, or if you need more information, you can leave us a message or, you know, by a comment below. If you don't want to miss any of our live session, please follow us on our Facebook page and also YouTube channel. So thank you for all your support today, and I hope to see you in the next video. Thank you, everyone. Goodbye.